professional actor. Have been for 40-odd years. It's pretty much all you know how to do, and you've been doing it well for most of this time. Somewhere down the line, producers gave you work in a theater, in films, in television. You were no risk. You came from a hungry breed who served their apprenticeship in hometown playhouses, road companies, and years of schooling under one of a half dozen masters from whose classes came just about every important actor around today. And you have a lot of talent. And so, you've been working pretty good these past years. Maybe not too many leads, but you were a hell of a supporting actor to Doris Day, David Niven, Audrey Hepburn, Jack Lemmon, Steve McQueen, Burt Reynolds. Because I'm off a receptive. This means you work pretty regularly. Maybe no magazine covers or gossip about you in the columns. But that's the price you pay for being married to the same woman for 31 years. Fan mail? Well, the postman never had to break his back delivering to you. And how about all those people who know the face but not quite sure of the name? That's what happens when you're not gorgeous. But you're an actor and doing what you do best. And then one day, man, it happens. The jackpot time. The Daily Double. The lead on the New York stage in Neil Simon's newest smash, California Suite. And across town, the second half of the double, top man in Warner Brothers' new film hit, The Ritz. Better just be the best. There's nobody who can resist me. I'm like a beautiful girl. But you never forgot the days and nights of washing dishes to survive, and the post office, and running an elevator.
Every time I do this and I think it's rough and I'm sweating a little and there are no laughs, I think of the elevator. What an elevator. If you own Park Central Hotel, it's now the Sheraton on 7th Avenue. I used to work there all night so I could make rounds in the daytime and there was like 20 minutes a night for sleeping. The post office was... It was 10, on a scale of 10, compared to an elevator, it was about a 3. It was really rough. My hands used to get split and bleeding from the cords that I had to pop open every night. Dishwashing wasn't too bad. If you like dishes. I used to rotate from night jobs. I used to be fired at one night job and go to another. But you had to do that because you had to exist. It was all a question of survival to get to this dressing room and these lights and to pursue the dream that led to the elevator and to the dishes and to the post office and to giving blood for the Red Cross and to selling shoes and to practically begging. And it was 3 years of a rough struggle. We used to make rounds all day long. We used to walk over to Sardi's restaurant for the quickie, the cheapie, that we could get a quick drink and some free lunch there.
Well, we really were instrumental in making Jack Weston a big star. You know, all those free meals he used to get there and the free food at the bar. Well, he was a big failure when he was skinny, and now that he's fat, fattened up by Sardi's, he's a success.
Vincent Sardi was always terrific to the actors. And we compared notes about who did what and who's casting. It was a terrific, terrific kick. Jimmy Dean and Steve McQueen. Oh, God, a bunch of us. Jerry Stiller and Mira. We always used to sit around and cry and scream and moan and complain.
How did I start out? I was washing windows in Long Island City in projects.
He was always very quiet and very still. He still is, but he's a terrific actor.
The nice thing about watching Jack Weston make it, finally, is that finally, his peers, everyone in the business, who have known it all these years, are beginning to appreciate it. Because it's nice to know that if someone like Jack is doing it, it's going to happen for the rest of us, too. And he's one of the guys, so to speak, and he's a beautiful actor to work with.
I took directing classes with Lee Strasberg. And in the class, the volunteer actresses at that time, all unknown, were people like Eva Marie Saint, Colleen Dougherty, and Rod Steiger was one of the students, and we all had a ball. It was marvelous because we were all young and we were were all in pursuit of that dream.
Burt Reynolds, my buddy.
Burt learned the centerfold from me. I was much thinner then, you've got to believe it. Much thinner. But, I, of course, advised him not to do the centerfold, and he didn't take my advice and became a superstar. And as a result of that, he hired me to work in a picture called Gator with him that he directed and starred in with me.
Well, what the hell's going on? Have you got him or not?
We temporarily lost him.
Ken. Come in, Ken.
In spite of everything I taught him, he's still a hit. Go figure that out. Back side, Neil Simon wrote this beautiful play called California Suite, and he said...
Jack who? Weston, Weston. I discovered Jack Weston in a small theater right here in Ecuador, and he was... he wasn't on the stage, he was on the floor trying to pick up pieces of candy that the people had dropped. But I worked with Jack for many, many years, and I would say today that Jack is a consummate actor. He consumes everything in sight. That's Jack Weston.
He wrote the part I'm playing with me in mind, which flatters me terrifically. And this and the Ritz are the two happiest times I've ever had on the stage.
I had a marvelous time doing it because I worked with a marvelous cast. Jack Weston, Rita Moreno, Kay Ballard. And also, I got a chance to play a villain for the first time in my life.
And I play a garbage sanitation owner from Cleveland, Ohio, who's escaping from his relatives who want to do him in. And I wind up in New York in a gay bathhouse.
Huh? Oh, it was just a person.
She called you boss.
A lot of people call me boss. It's not what you're going to think of me.
Vespucci Enterprises, Inc. Carmine Vespucci, President. This is a statement.
I was going to tell you about it.
We own this place?
Papa done a lot of expanding while you're in Cleveland.
We own this place, Guy.
You don't have to know the family business stuff. Now, come on, this isn't the place to talk about it.
You knew what kind of a place this was all the time.
Rita Moreno plays Googie Gomez, a down-in-the-heels Puerto Rican entertainer who wants to sing. And she doesn't sing too well in the picture, but she sings beautifully off the stage. And I bump into Rita there, who thinks I'm a producer, and I can get her into show business.
I heard on the grapevine she's going to be a big producer out in the front watching your show tonight, unquote.
Someday, you're going to see the name of Googie Gomez in lights, and you're going to say that yourself? Was that her? And then you're going to answer to yourself, that was her. But you know something, mister? I was always her, just nobody knows it.
Who the hell was that?
Crazy Rita.
Did he really say that?
She's terrific.
I love him. I really love him.
She's vivacious.
I want to play the South American girls from the movies, you know. I could be another Lana Turner, or I could be Barbara Streisand, Betty Midler.
Fabulous actress. She's such a good performer.
He and I just think that the other is the funniest person in the world. He thinks I'm very funny, too. So after having done that play, The Ritz, for 1 year on the stage, and breaking up all the time during that year, by the way, we did it again in the movie.
On the stage and on the screen, I think it's one of the best times I've ever had in my life.
The best? That's the best.
We had such fun. When we did the picture, it was just a carryover. We had to literally control ourselves from just breaking up because the material was so funny. And I tend to relate to California Suite and to The Ritz as being really the pinnacle of, you know, of a career. They've both been starring roles and they've both been so rewarding in terms of people's reactions. And if I want to name time, the time I put in to get to last year and this year, 40 years. 40 years. That's from when I was a kid, about 10, 11 years old, to now. Of working and wanting and dreaming and scheming and getting a dressing room and a lot of money and my name and lights and it. 40 big years. It's all worked. It's been terrific.
You're Jack Weston, a professional actor. Tonight, you're really on top. And maybe tomorrow, you'll still be there, and for many tomorrows after that. But if you have to go back and mix with a Steve McQueen, Burt Reynolds, or Jack Lemmon and take second billing, you'll do that too, and do the very best job you can. And that's as good as there is.